Now Chubb running right. And they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. They'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
I like the strategy. Extra tight ends, extra beef. They want to run the football. But that means they probably want to run it inside. If you get strung out on the perimeter, you're in peril.
Yeah, we saw the result. Negative yardage. So after the loss of a yard, they'll look to push forward here on second down and 11. Now Allen. And the defense has it covered. It's intercepted. Picked up by Javon Holland.
They went for the deep shot early, and that's fine, but I don't think it was the right target to throw it to. You had three of the guys sprinting downfield, and I thought two of them were open. Could have avoided an interception there by attacking a different player in coverage.
Now a play fake here on first down. That one caught by Tyreek Hill. And he's tackled at the 38, but they doubled their yardage. The play started at the 19, and they gained 19. From all the way up at the 40, after a good start to the drive. Now a handoff up the middle. Kidd. And this winds up a pickup of two, maybe two and a half, to about the 39. The Dolphins at 10-6 now on the year. They have certainly got it rolling as of late, winners of six in a row.
And I think this is where, as a head coach, you show your team some trust. Instead of just talking about winning, you know, the very next game, you point out to them, we're on a nice run here. If we keep doing this, we'll be playing at home in the postseason. And we know that that could ride us all the way to the Super Bowl if we get that done.
The Dolphin passing game rolling here. They've got another first down. Now a give, right side, Kidd. And he's got this down to the 35. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down.
Usually we see runs like this as the defense breaks down later in the game, but this guy's setting the tone early, running through all types of tackles and put the defense back on its heels.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. They'll look to throw here. This will be covered. It's Waddle. Touchdown. Jalen Waddle with touchdown number 12 on the year. And the Dolphins take the early turnover and convert it into an opening touchdown. Extra point up and down. The score 7-0. Kicking team out for Miami as they will send this one away.
Push it downfield, offense.
Take it in at the 3. Now he brings us out past the 20 to the 24. Come to the line to start their next drive. A thrown interception the first time they had the football wound up leading to a touchdown the other way. How do you approach drive number two?
Going back to your game plan coming in, everyone has matchups that they like better than others, where they think they have an advantage. Dial up some of those plays. Try and go to those spots and get your offense moving.
They start on the ground with Nick Chubb. His speed, if he just finds the slightest crease, he can take it the distance like he did there.
How about the leverage up front? Offensive line out leveraging the defensive front to create that space, that crease that he was looking for. And once he hits open field, he's going to be very difficult to catch and corral.
Extra point by Blankenship is up and good, and we are tied at 7.
Let's go!
So I'll leave it at 7 now as they kick it away. From the 6. And some good special teams coverage as they bring him down just outside of the 15. First down, Miami, as they get set to start the drive. Even though they might not find the number one seed next to their name come playoff time, there's not going to be very many teams, if any, entering the playoffs on the kind of run they're on. They're hot.
And I love that word, hot, because every team in the league wants to go into the playoffs on that uptick. Because a lot of the time, you serve notice to the rest of the league that, hey, we're the team you need to deal with. We're the team that's going to be a real problem for you.
Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. Points 1, 2, and 3 in their defensive game plan was to get to the quarterback and knock the ball free. They did it there. Luckily, offense hangs on to it.
Yeah, that's got to serve as a wake-up call, though, because they can't afford to let the ball go over to the defense and miss opportunities. And I'm not saying it happened here, but you know what a good rule of thumb is when a play like that occurs? You know who usually recovers it? The guy who missed his block and let his quarterback get hit.
He had the touchdown earlier. This one's going to get him a first down.
But I think when they look at their offense, they think to themselves, weapons, weapons everywhere. And they want to move the ball around. They want to spread it to different people. But you absolutely know they want to get this man involved as well. And that's what they just did on that play.
And some oohs and ahs from the crowd as he jukes his way forward for a couple of yards. The last run good for 2. Here's 2nd and 8. They'll drop the throw. This throw incomplete. Now the defender all over him that time, and it's going to lead to 3rd down.
Well, they've got man coverage on the outside, and my scouting report on these DBs tells me that they love to take matters in their own hands. They want man coverage, not zone. And there was good coverage there that forced the incompletion.
On 3rd down, he'll drop the throw. That's into a sea of bodies, and it's intercepted. Tre'Davious White with a pick. And he is going to score. It's a pick 6 and a Bills touchdown.
Coaches preach all the time about opportunities and taking advantage of them, and he did exactly that. I used to have a coach told us all the time, a lost opportunity is never regained. Well, no regrets here. He picked that one off and took it to the house.
So they throw the pick 6. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. From the 6. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17. The Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive. Now remember, they were just out here a moment ago through the pick 6, so we'll see if they can take better care of the football this go around.
And sometimes, partner, I think it's almost better that you just throw the pick 6 and you come right back out on the field. You're not over on the sidelines dwelling for it for very long. You're not hearing everyone say, hey, you'll get them next time. Hey, don't worry about it. All that stuff just goes right out the window. You're right back out on the field with a chance to atone.
And they'll send the slot in motion left. On 1st down, he'll drop to throw. And this is incomplete. Very lucky to get that one back. That nearly picked. It's 2nd down now.
Well, nearly another interception there. That would have been 2 drives in a row with a pick. He's got to start taking care of the ball way better than what we're seeing.
Interestingly, that throw was probably worse than the one he threw the interception on last drive, but fell incomplete. Now a nice throw here, right side. He hauls it in. Now he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's 1st and 10, just outside the 30. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. And going deep for Hill. And it's intercepted at the goal line.
picked off by Micah Hyde.
And the Bills are going to get the football here as the ball will come out to the 20.
If you combine last week and this week, he's got a hat trick going because he had two interceptions a week ago.
He's seeing the ball so well and understanding where receivers are and positioning. I mean, just watching him work with such great technique and paying it off by actually catching the ball when he has a chance, he's helping his team in a huge way.
They begin this drive with Chubb. Fights forward for only about a yard up to the 21. Through one quarter, 14-7 our score. Here's second and nine, just a yard on that last run. Here's Allen to throw it. And his throw is incomplete.
Well, he certainly thought he had a window to push that ball downfield, but as soon as he released the throw, the corner was there to
save him. Second down, that'll leave him trying to convert on third and nine. Throwing now is Allen. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. Dangerous spot for them to cough it up. Lucky to have recovered because had the defense got it, they were already within a shadow of the goalpost.
Yeah, and then you're yelling at your own defense. Sudden change, sudden change. That's not what you want to hear on your sideline. That means you've got to run out there and try and stop an offense who has the ball in a very advantageous position.
Call it 46 yards on the punt, just a single yard on the return as he was covered quickly. And it'll be Dolphin football.
Ready up.
First down Miami as they get set to start the drive.
As the offense comes out here, Charles, remember they threw the interception last time out, but they were moving the football down the field. Looked like they were going to have a sustained drive that ended in points, but then the pick ensued.
And because of that, there's no way you can call the last drive a success. Yes, there are things to build on because they found some play calls at work. Now they've got to build another drive and find a way to avoid the turnover the play did on the last one.
The play action fake. They'll look to throw. Throw outside here, complete to the tight end, Gesicki. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets them up for third down.
A lot of tight ends just use their size and their strength, try to occupy some space and kind of body people away and catch the football. But not this guy. He's a refined route runner. Makes me wonder if he took some dance classes in his background with his football.
Back to throw here. He is going to find Hill here.
And he is going to have the Dolphins first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
So first and 10 now in Buffalo territory at the 48-yard line.
And they'll run the end around here with Judy.
And that play goes nowhere. Taken down, losing yardage at the 50, right at midfield. 2 yards the loss, second and 12. From the midfield strike, they'll look to throw.
That's going to be caught by Waddle.
And he's got a first down as a tackle made at the Bills' 31-yard line. They'll set up a throw. Touchdown, Dolphins! Jerry Judy, 31 yards!
And the Dolphins are an extra point away from drawing level.
Extra point up and Sanders, and we are tied at 14. This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Bills come to the line to start their next drive as we grind toward the end of the season here, and they haven't had the season that they had hoped. So let me ask you to play GM. Where might they look to make some changes?
I think when you look into the upcoming draft, think hard about them drafting multiple offensive linemen. They've got to get stouter up front. And as a GM always tells me, Charles, this is a big boy league, and big people always end up winning games for you.
Now, man, open down the middle of the field. Now he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. 33 yards that time.
A very nice job right there, working the middle of the field, able to create some separation, and then utilize it to not just make the catch, but turn up field once he got the ball in his hands.
Throwing on first down is Allen. And the screen unsuccessfully dropped him.
Everything about that play tells you about today's NFL offenses and what they're asking out of running backs. You can't just be a guy who can run the football. You have to be able to catch it as well. And he didn't get that done on that play.
Allen's throw taken in by Diggs. And he's got another first down as he's brought down at the Dolphins 16. A nice pickup of 17 yards. So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. From the red zone now, they look to throw. Touchdown, Bills! Dawson Knox, he has career touchdown number 78, tying in with both Eddie George and Frank Gifford on the all-time list. And the Bills have broken the tie. Extra point by Blankenship is up and good. And the lead is now 21-14. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. Well, not one you see often there as he fails to keep it between the sidelines, and that is a penalty every time. And going to give this offense better field position.
And it's every kickoff guy's nightmare, isn't it? Because you don't see yourself doing this. And most of the time you don't. It's absolutely a miss hit, and now your team pays the price. Bad field position for your defense.
And he takes this up right near the 45-yard line. And we've hit the two-minute mark in this first half of action.
Score on these guys.
Here we go.
Second and five. They'll keep it on the ground. Kidd. And a good run here as he'll run all the way down to the 40-yard line. They go play action here on first down. And get this to his tight end, Gesicki. And he gets this down inside the 35 before going out of bounds. So the completion good for seven there. And that's going to bring up second down. And the slot man goes in motion left. Second and three. Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and it's going to be a first down. Well done. A good pickup there, 26 yards.
And this has been a nice answer to the touchdown a few minutes ago because they've come out and reestablished the tempo. A nice throw there, and they're putting together a very strong drive as a response.
Looking to throw. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. And just shy of the goal line as he's out of bounds right at the one. That's good for a gain of six, second and goal.
And good yardage there on first down because sometimes all you need to do on the screen is get one key block. That might set your man free, and that was pretty good pursuit to the football defensively, or it could have gone for more.
Second and goal from the one. They'll try the left side. Kidd, and he takes it into the end zone for the Dolphin touchdown. A great effort there. With touchdown number 23 here on the year. And the Dolphins are within an extra point of tying up the teams locked into a good one here. 21 all the score as the kick's away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Bills come to the line to start their next drive. There was still more than a minute to go in the half. Time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity. You can never have enough points with the high-powered offenses that you face. And analytics will tell you, try and score when given the opportunity.
On second and inches, Allen. Going down the middle, and it's complete. And he has a big gain inside the 40 before being dropped. Now the Bills are going to use the first of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with just under 50 seconds remaining in half number one. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. The give running right is Chubb. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
Part of the thinking when you bring in extra tight ends, you're hoping that each of your guys gets those one-on-one blocks and creates a crease for your runner. But the converse is, though, you've got to win those one-on-one blocks. And when you don't, that's the result you end up with.
So the first down run lost a couple. Now they come up second and 12. A throw there, but that's going to wind up incomplete. Time he's lost a fumble. This one hurts more. It's returned for six.
He's been under a lot of duress, hasn't he? Pressure, hurry, harass the whole game.
Well, the offensive line not giving him a lot of help.
Not a lot of help, but the bottom line, he's got to take care of the football.
And goodbye, Sanders. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. Bills come to the line to start their next drive. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Good strong throw and catch right there. And so far in this game, the alleys have been open for them to get completions, and they're taking advantage of it.
So one play, and they're already just shy of midfield. Allen, off the play fake. And he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. Now a timeout. 7 seconds left in the first half. Sacks a growing theme in this first half. This is second and long. Try after the first down sack. Allen, he's going to launch this thing right downfield. And that will be incomplete. So we've reached halftime in a wild first half. We'll take a minute to catch our breath as we'll send you up to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman and our EA Sports Halftime Report. And we welcome you back now alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn getting set for quarter number three here. The Dolphins in front, and they'll be in possession of the football first as the second half gets started. And they will not get a chance to return this one. It's through the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive. As this offense takes the field to begin the opening drive of the second half, Charles, remember that first half, good through the air, really all around, an outstanding offensive performance.
Absolutely. They reached the end zone several times. The passing game working awfully well, and most importantly, partner.
And they went to the tunnel with a lead. They come back out with that lead.
Absolutely. NFL coaches, we know they're perfectionists in a lot of ways, but they had to like what they saw in that first half.
Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense the next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one.
And he'll go down right around the 47 this time. 44 yards rushing now on 8 carries for him so far.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football. Sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. It's a loss of 4 there, bringing up second down. And look like some movement there. Let's get the call. Oh, jumping early from his tight end spot. Maybe try to get a jump start on that route.
Yeah, I think you're exactly right about that. And oftentimes when you see that, that means the play call was supposed to come in his direction, and he was eager to go catch a pass.
Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. Crossing the field and bringing it in. And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful you're losing playing against a good quarterback like he is to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I mean, it's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, you go to a zone blitz game. And you can drop anyone out of your defensive front, defensive end, defensive tackle. It doesn't matter. You just exchange someone to bring more pressure towards the quarterback and still try and cover downfield.
Yeah, give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and 6.
Let's just make this one succinct. Nice job there. All 11 guys on defense diagnosing the jet sweep and putting it down.
Coming up on a 2nd and 6. They'll look to throw. And that'll fall incomplete. He was hit just as he let that go. And now it's 3rd down. They don't get the hook up there, but you really have to marvel at how precise he's been throwing the football these last couple weeks.
Oh, that's the perfect word for it, precise. Because if you're at 70% or better, 2 weeks in a row, you have a job as long as you want one in this league, won't you? I mean, let's face it, it's not just West Coast offense either. He's putting the ball downfield as well.
In motion, Hill. Now back to throw. He's got it. Touchdown, Dolphins. Tyreek Hill, 31 yards. And the Dolphins go up by 2 touchdowns. Extra point up and good by Sanders. And the lead now up to 14. Kicking team out for Miami as they will send this one away. This fielded right at the goal line. And no alley to be found. The coverage was solid, and he's dropped at the 18. The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. They make their second half debut here, and things are looking a little bit tougher now. You give up the points there, Charles, that touchdown drive on the other side. So now it's a 2-score game here. Got to be careful.
They certainly do, and I'm just wondering at halftime if those guys just looked into each other's eyes and realized what they've got to get done and come out a little bit more charged up, because if they don't get some kind of points here, that next drive, that could make this a 3-possession game.
Allen now on 1st down. Got it complete to Khalil Shakir. And he'll be tackled right on the chalk of the 45. It's a gain of 13 and a Buffalo first down. Here's Allen. Over the middle into traffic, and that's complete. They'll give him 4 yards there, and that'll bring up second down.
They kept the receiver in the short field, but that let his quarterback get the ball quickly to him before either guy in double coverage could react.
They go with Chubb on second down. That's a run ball now. And he will finally be taken out of bounds.
124 yards rushing for him now as he is finishing off the regular season with a bang.
So close. Couldn't get all the way in. Knocking on the doorstep down to the one. Nevertheless, fantastic run.
Not only that, this is where you wave to your replacement, go back to the bench. No way. I'm not coming out of this game. I got it down to the one-yard line. I want to carry it in.
We'll see if they reward him on this next play.
Chubb will score. Touchdown, Buffalo.
So a strong drive here to lead off this third quarter and gets him right back in this football game.
And I think we can safely call that a statement drive because they had to be saying, we have put our best foot forward in the first half, but we certainly mean business now. Maybe a better term, a prove-it drive. They proved it to themselves that they were ready to go.
This game back within a touchdown now as the kickoff's away.
Takes it at the 7. And beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21.
First down Miami as they get set to start the drive.
Pretty important third quarter drive for them. Momentum has sort of shifted the other direction after that last touchdown as they nurse this small lead.
And he is going to lose yardage here. He was unable to shake free there. They'll cover him for a loss of a yard.
Heck of a play there to get to him quickly and get him down for a loss.
I think they did a really nice job getting ready for this game, scouting, watching film, and understanding defensively what the play design was.
And he's upended after a gain of 4 up to the 25-yard line.
Good reactions there defensively. That screen was a little slow in developing, and they shut that one down with little gain.
Here we go. An extra defensive back here for the Bills on third down. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And able to find Gesicki as tight end. And he is going to have the Dolphins first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 37-yard line. It's a loss of 4 on the first down play. They'll have to deal with a 2nd and 14 now after the loss. In motion, Hill. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
Looked like both sides were anticipating a quick throw there, and the defense was ready to jump in and deny it, and they did.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. He'll drop to throw.
And that nearly the pick that they needed. He couldn't pull it in, though, and it's 4th down.
The Dolphins will send out the punter now as he's on a punt for the first time this afternoon. He was only asked to punt once in the victory last week as he sends this one away. They'll net only 35 here following a 43-yard boot, 8-yard return. And the Bills will take over the football with a 1st and 10. The Bills come to the line to start their next drive.
As the offense begins another drive here, pretty simple, Charles. They want to carbon copy what happened the last time out when they ended their drive in the end zone.
You're right about that, partner. Sounds pretty simple, doesn't it? Just score again, but we know it's not that simple because we don't just make adjustments at halftime if you're a good football team. You spend that time on the sideline, you study what's on the notes and the tablets, and you make those adjustments for one repeated pass drive. Series to series, the best teams, that's how they get it done.
And we'll find out here soon enough whether those adjustments are...
First down, they'll run with Chubb. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine.
Another good run for him. What else is new? That'll put him right at 150 yards for the game, so he's really made his presence felt in this one.
The run only got a yard. Here's second and nine. They run it again with Chubb. And this will be stopped at the 44. That one good for 7 yards.
This type of running back, I mean, this size, this intensity, usually gets balls again. Just a lot of experience in those 3 yards. You need to run up there. I'm going to tackle this guy. By the fourth quarter, you're coming up and thinking about it.
And D-line wearing down fourth quarter. Yeah, that's not a guy they want to see consistently. And that one going nowhere for the start as he's met in the backfield and goes backwards. That'll back him up 2 yards and also bring up fourth.
Now they try to catch him by surprise there on third down, but this defense, they were all over the jet sweep.
And it's oftentimes all about what you're doing on the backside of the defense, whether it's the defensive end or the outside backer, who's setting the edge. And if they don't get blown off the line of scrimmage, they can really wreck a play. And in this case, they were able to make the tackle for a loss as a result.
One final try here for Allen. And he's going to be marked down just inside the 35.
Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
Here's Allen on first and 10. And he's going to be taken down. Pressure gets there back at the 39-yard line. Emmanuel Ogba that time, able to drop him for a loss.
And this dominant defensive performance continued on that play. This poor quarterback has not received the protection he needs and has had to pick himself up off the turf far too often.
And he gets it to his running back, Nick Chubb.
And he'll be brought down at the 27.
And that was yardage that they needed there after the sideline first down. They didn't get a little bit back. But now they look at third down as a manageable situation. Whether they have a multiple chance.
And he'll be marked down right at the 20-yard line.
But they certainly had success throughout this contest getting him the ball in the passing game, and there he picks up another first down. Whatever they saw going into this one, they've been able to capitalize on it, and no adjustment has been made to take it away.
The drive continues as they search for a tying touchdown. Here's first and 10. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw.
After that throw, and it was definitely one that he would love to have back, I wonder what's going through his head. I wonder what kind of mind game he's playing with himself to get himself back on track. Because a lot of guys, that's what they do. They have little triggers that when the mechanics are off, if they make a bad throw, that they go to that place to get themselves back in sync.
Touchdown! Nick Chubb, a 20-yard touchdown.
And the Bills are an extra point away from tying this game here in the fourth.
Don't forget the extra point. It's up and good. And we are tied here in the fourth quarter. So here comes the kickoff now, all even here in this fourth quarter.
So now the possession will begin at the 35 after the errant kickoff.
Well, that's certainly one way to avoid a dangerous kick returner, I suppose, but you are giving up extra yardage, that's for sure. Because if you put it out of the end zone, they start at the 25. So at a minimum, you're giving up 10 yards to the offense.
Good starting field position for the Dolphins as they have it first and 10 at the 40. Up the middle they go. Kidd, and he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11.
Go.
They'll look to throw here. Open man downfield is Waddle. He's got it. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. 23 yards the pickup there. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. On play action, they'll throw. And he rifles one incomplete.
His back has been a dependable safety valve all game, so he went back to him when his first read was covered. Just unable to connect, so the play results in no gain.
And second and 10, he'll look to throw again. And he's got his tight end, it's Mike Gesicki. And now for him on the season, that is his 80th catch, and the result is a first down. Now again, right side, Kidd, and not able to break away this time as they're going to stop him right around the line of scrimmage. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed allowed for great penetration as they stuffed that one behind the line of scrimmage. It certainly didn't appear that that's where he wanted to go with the ball initially, so he tried to get something out of it by dumping it off to his running back unsuccessfully.
Here we go,
possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is third and long. They'll drop to throw. Got a man. It's Judy complete. Well, this is going to depend on the spot, but it's not a very generous one. He looks to be about a yard or so short. They'll get 10 there, but it leaves them just short for fourth down.
Receivers love having the reputation of being go-to guys on third down, and he was fighting like he really wanted to have that reputation, didn't he? I mean, he came very close to making that a first down.
Broke the one tackle, but couldn't spring himself free.
Here we go. Yellow.
Slot man moves right.
38. Hey, hey,
and they'll send the slot in motion left.
Red, yellow. Ultra. Go out. Trail green. Hut, hut.
Back to throw here. And he's got his tight end Gesicki in the end zone. Touchdown, Dolphins. An 11-yard touchdown. Dolphins answer back with a touchdown of their own to break our tie and take the lead here in the fourth. The kicking team out for Miami as they will send this one away. And that one carries out of the side of the end zone here, so it's a touchback and bring it out to the 25. The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. The offense running out, and they are charged up, ready to go after reaching the end zone on their last drive.
And normally I would warn against getting complacent just because they scored the last time out. But I don't think there's any worse with this group right now. This is a hunger group, and they want to keep building it for their last drive. Now they just want the officials to hurry up and place the ball so they can snap it and get back to work.
To another on-target throw, and that last one, Charles, going to put him up over 5,000 yards passing out for the season, and that is not an insignificant number.
Indeed, it is not, because this is not a big list, and most of the guys on it, Drew Brees, Peyton Manning, Tom Brady, Dan Marino, they either are or will be Hall of Famers.
And he can't get a throw away. He's is taken down. Chain Timber in there to take him down, and the clock will roll.
And it has been a rough afternoon for him trying to get rid of the football. See, that's now 5 sacks.
How'd you like to be the offensive coordinator, the offensive line coach, trying to come up with an answer for this pass rush? What blocking assignments do you change? Can guys play a little bit better? And we're seeing the end result.
So the 14 yards actually takes him from 143 to the other for first and 10. Now a handoff up the middle. Kidd.
And he fights forward for a modest 2-yard gain. Second down.
Now the Bills are going to use the first of their timeouts as they stop it here with just under 40 seconds to go in the game.
Ready?
The play action fake. They'll look to throw. And that is incomplete.
I see the surprise in your face there, partner. That is a rare incompletion from him. He's been on point this entire game.
He has percentage completion-wise way up. Not that time. The line to gain is the 33 on third down. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. Sliding out of the pocket. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked off by Micah Hyde. And the Bills are going to take possession here at their own 33.
They exited the pocket trying to improvise. That was a tough throw, and unfortunately, it wound up in the wrong pair of hands.
And Brandon, when you're on the run, sometimes your downfield vision can get skewed just a bit. Now, the beauty of extending a play is sometimes your receivers find their way open, but oftentimes you end up closing down part of the field and bringing those defenders to the ball. And that one was picked off.
Now the Bills will use the second of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 18 seconds remaining. Here's Allen. Finding Knox there, complete. He's got room at the 30. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. And 22 more yards there and another first down. Allen. And the comeback may stall out. It's intercepted. And the Dolphins have just about sewn up this football game.
Counting now 6 interceptions between last week and this week. Now the 3 picks last week helped them to a win. They're in the driver's seat once more.
And they're the ones that are doing all the leading, aren't they? Right? The 3 interceptions last week, that led to a victory. 3 interceptions so far in this game, that puts them out in front. We often think of the offense driving things. In this case, it's the defense, not just holding teams, but creating big plays for themselves.
Charles, normally when you see a group score this many points, it's a complete blowout. But instead, they needed every single one of those in this close, high-scoring affair.
And Brandon, I'm still on the edge of my seat after that one, because when you have that much scoring and it still comes down to one possession game at the end, that's not something we see very often. And in this case, these offenses, they brought it. The defenses, they're going to need some work going forward.
So for Miami, the win here in Week 18 gives them a pivotal 11th win on the year, running their final mark to 11-6. And now they'll await the final seeding for the playoffs ahead. Meanwhile, for the Bills, it will indeed be a 10-loss season as...
Told my boss, it ain't no limit. Told all my dogs, it ain't no limit. Put your head in the game, head in the game, head in the game. Head in the game, head in
I'm
the game.
I'm living in track, I was messed up suspension. I drove it so fast that I flew out the engine. I kept it too real ever since the beginning. I play offensive D, I might switch my position. La mama was thirsty, so I had to quench. I'ma drive real fast, cause you know I shoot quick. Just like Travis Kelce, I be having emotions. Just like a lamb, I ain't know I'm exploding. My heart cold, babe, I ain't got emotions. I'm going hard, yeah, you know I'm devoted. We running streets, yeah, you know we control it. She love the kids, she be busting it over. I'm quarterbacking like I'm Kyler Murray. Trying to win, I'm up at practice early. Going crazy, I just ripped my jersey. It's the first half, and we done drop 30.
We just underscoring them, boy.
I told my boss, it ain't no limits. Told all my dogs, it ain't no limits. Put your head in the game, head in the game, head in the game. Head in the game, head in the game.
Money on my mind, head in the game. It's like I scored again, diamonds on them dance. I can hear the music playing with the band. Crowd going wild, dived in the fan. I'm locking in on a mission, it's time for my vision. You young and she get like me. I got your shorty, she with me. I gave her a jersey, I told her to join my team. It's best you go with a safe, you know how I play. I get to a sack like Frank. You can teach money to fly, I turn it a hop. I catch it and go to the bank. It's crazy, I'm used to the lights, I'm shining so bright. It's visor to cover my face. You see me working, I'm working, I'm getting it done. As soon as you feed me grapes.
Yeah. I told my boss, it ain't no limits. Told all my dogs, it ain't no limits. Put your head in the game. I told my boss, it ain't no limit. Told all my dogs, it ain't no limit. Put your head in the game, head in the game, head in the game. Head in the game, head in the game.
I'm whipping in track, I was messed up suspension. I drove it so fast that I blew out the engine. I kept it too real ever since the beginning. I play offensive D, I might switch my position.
I told my boss, it ain't no limit. Told all my dogs, it ain't no limit. Put your head in the game, head in the game, head in the game. Head in the game, head in the game.
I'm whipping in track, I was messed up suspension. I drove it so fast that I blew out the engine. I kept it too
real. I told my boss, it ain't no limit. Told all my dogs, it ain't no limit. Put your head in the game, head in the game, head in the game. Head in the game, head in the game.
I'm whipping in track, I was messed up suspension. I drove it so fast.